Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice.
It's showtime.
I feel so good. I feel so damn yeah.
So, as a few of you probably know, I recently went with my wife to Rockfest 2019. We actually got our 3-year wedding anniversary gift from each other. We felt a 3.5 days of concert, a great thing to do, strengthen our relationship, and you know what, motherfucker, it was great. We went camping for the very first time ever, and during the weather we had that weekend, it was that week. It was probably the best that we weren't out in the middle of the woods. Holy shit, was over there. But I'm here to give you a overview of the weekend. So we're going to go ahead and start with Wednesday night. Wednesday night, we got to my father-in-law's. We got Andy's place at probably like 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon, well after we wanted to. But, you know, who the fuck cares, right? I mean, you know, best laid plans and all. Got the tent set up, which only took like an hour and a half to get the whole thing set up and packed full of everything that a grown boy and girl would want. Bed, pillows, 2 side tables, 2 easy chairs even. Val, the wife, she put up an amazing little tube light set up. That was gorgeous, by the way. If we have any footage of it, I'll make sure that it goes up on YouTube shortly. It's pretty incredible. It was actually pretty romantic, very nice. She put the bouquet that I bought for her for our 2-year anniversary in the tent. It was a nice time. So anyway, we got done on Wednesday night with the setup and time to go see Boba Flex, which was the bonus game for Wednesday night. Boba Flex, you may see fucking literally me with my fucking guns on right here, boys. It's our second time seeing the band. You're fucking phenomenal live. I got some great shots here that I'll be done in post. You know, they played Bear Me with my guns on. Mama, don't take my drugs away. God, Jesus, they played so many songs. I saw almost their whole set. There was a phenomenal act. They're out of, I want to say that they're out of Kentucky. No, Georgia. Georgia, Kentucky, I know. Added in post. The 2 family members are from the famous McCoy family of the Hatfields and McCoys, which is why, unfortunately, in September they're disbanding. Long story short, I think his name is Marty McCoy. He's leaving the band permanently to go be a father to his kids, which I think is a very admirable choice. But the important thing is that they put on one hell of a show that night, and they had that tent fucking begging for more. Great show. Go see Boba Fletts if you ever get the chance in the next 6 weeks. Otherwise, if you don't catch them before the end of September, they will be forming a new band as of November. Starting November. I don't know which week, but the vocalist did announce that he and the rest of the band will be grabbing a new lead guitarist after his brother leaves, and they will be making a new band. So it'll be very interesting to see what the hell they do afterwards. Anyway, next day started with absolute, just abysmal heat. First band, dope, at 12:50, dope. Die, motherfucker, die. Janie is crying. Fucking, I don't know, ton of great songs, to be honest. I've been listening to them since I was 20 years old, so 13 years now. Phenomenal band. I don't actually know a terrible amount about their individual players, but they were great. Edsel continuously complained about having to be up and on stage at, you know, 12:50 in the afternoon, which I don't blame him for when he guys was used to, you know, probably performing at about 11 o'clock at night. So he's probably not used to being up until about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Because, you know, probably stairs up until 4 or 5 in the morning, doing whatever. But, you know, whatever. I mean, he's been doing this for 20 years. He can guide in, do whatever the hell he will pleases, right? Anyway, they put on a stellar performance. It's almost guaranteed right now that he is, in fact, Zero, the vocalist performing with Static X, who we'll get to in a few minutes, but they had an absolutely excellent set as well. So Dope was fantastic. Next up on Thursday was Devil Driver. Fucking Devil Driver, motherfuckers. They opened their set with Oath of the Abyss, and that was one of the greatest sets that I've ever seen. It obviously was. Fantastic death metal band. Played Oath of the Abyss, played Back with a Vengeance, played The Appetite, played Sail. A whole bunch of great songs. Honestly, if you ever want to catch a really great groove death metal band, catch Devil Driver. They're on tour right now with Static X, Dope, and Wednesday 13. Fucking rock on forever. Next up there was Starset. Starset of the Starset Society. Their frontman, funny enough, is actually a member of NASA. This is what he does in his free time, believe it or not. He has a galactic rock band. Absolutely phenomenal fucking act, by the way. If you ever want to see what a genius level IQ does in their free time, go see Starset. They played My Demons, they played Carnivore. Honestly, they played like a 10 or 12 song set in like 45 minutes. I was really fucking impressed. And he talked in between every single song, by the way. He really got to know his audience. Fantastic showmanship, absolutely phenomenal onstage energy. It was great stuff. All right, so next up was Skillet. Skillet is a god rock band out of, I believe they are from Chicago. Or at least they're from Illinois, I believe. Actually, the god rock part didn't come into play too much. Once, maybe twice, the vocalist mentioned stuff about how, you know, he finds faith in everyday acts, but really wasn't that too pervasive. And me being a person who doesn't believe in Christ or Christianity, I found that very pleasing. Not gonna lie, it was a very non-secular act, and they played their asses off. And frankly, if you're not gonna go see them just because they're a Christian rock band, then frankly, you're really missing out on a great act. They played phenomenally well, and you should really go catch them. They are on tour for us in the year. I believe they're with Breaking Benjamin right now. You can certainly go to their website and check it out. I'm sure they have all their tour dates listed. Next up was close to the end of Thursday night. It was Mastodon. I've never gotten to see these guys in person before. I've been listening to them since probably 2009, I guess. Heard about them when I was in college. They're a stoner metal band, is what they call themselves. And I would actually say that they're very closely akin to Tool. They're fucking amazingly good. Holy shit! I mean, holy fucking shit! You want to see a band fucking play their asses off for you? Go see fucking Mastodon, seriously. Their act is up there with fucking Sabbath, Iron Maiden, fucking The Rolling Stones, AC/DC. You want to talk about a band that could easily sell out Wembley Stadium if given the proper, band packaging? They're there. They are there. Mastodon is there. The laser show, the light show, the video show alone is just mind-bending. You don't even watch these guys when they're on stage, because what they have on in the background, you don't even watch these guys when they're on stage, because what they have on in the background is this mind-bending video for every single one of their songs. Their songs, by the way, are between 5 and 7 minutes long apiece. And in the maybe hour they were on stage, they talked
maybe a whole three times. Otherwise, every single moment that they were on stage, they were playing. Their drummer did not stop for more than 30 seconds during their entire set. I was fucking impressed. My God, they were good. Go see Mastodon. It's almost impossible for me to describe this band. They are Tool meets Soundgarden meets Killswitch Engage. And that's all the fucking more I'm gonna say about it. Go fucking see it. Next up on Thursday night was the amazing, the all fucking mighty Static Motherfucking X. I'm not even editing that. I don't care. Static X is a great goddamn show. I got to see them once, years and years and years ago. Back in yesteryear, you know, back when I was a young whippersnapper. Got to see them on Ozfest 06 when it was a free concert that year. When they had their Camel album out. They had so much energy, I was amazed that these guys were in like their late 30s. Now they're in their mid to late 40s. And let me tell you fucking something. The original fucking three band members, except for Wayne, who is of course unfortunately dead, just Wayne. They put on the same fucking show that they put on in their 20s. Apart from Rob Zombie, they probably had the most energetic show of any band at Rockfest. They were so loud, they were so energetic, they were so crazy. They had the entirety of Second Stage literally bumping. Literally bumping. I haven't seen a Second Stage audience do that shit in forever. The entirety of the audience was jumping in rhythm for 40 goddamn solid minutes. There was not a person standing still in the whole house. It was great. They played the entirety of Wisconsin Death Trip, and then they played fucking Kill Your Idols, and they played Cole. And that's when we erupted, and we had to do that thing that metalheads do, which, you know, is moshing. I know Rockfest, fuck you, because you don't like moshing. I don't care, and no one else did there either. We had a good time moshing, it was safe moshing, and goddamn it, we had fun. So moving right along here. And lastly for Thursday night, Evanescence. I talk shit about Evanescence in person. No one on this channel seems to talk shit about Evanescence, but I have. I will fully freely admit it. Amy Lee has been called a bitch in Rock News Online in multiple forms, multiple times over the last decade and a half, okay? You know, her original boyfriend from the band in their first few days, he left the band after they broke up because things got too toxic. She then dated Sean Morgan from Seether, who went to rehab for meth after they broke up. Yeah, I wonder who the fuck got him started on that. I'm not pointing any fingers here, but he did date Amy Lee, who was a narcissistic bitch. Any rate, sure Amy Lee will see us, and if she does, I just don't care right this minute. 10 years later, apparently she's learned her lesson, though, and to her I have to say, I'm sorry I talked shit about you before, because beforehand, you were a terrible fucking person who no one in the rock industry had anything nice to say about, frankly. Your label had to give you a new band because you didn't get along with anyone in your old band. That's a known fact. 3.5 years ago, Lou Brutus announced on Hard Drive XL on 9290X that you were being given a new band and going to put on a new album, which, by the way, you still haven't actually put out yet. That album is 7.5 years in the making now, so unfortunately you've kind of taken so long that people can draw their own conclusions. But that being stated, you're not a has-been, you're not washed up, and Amy Lee, you put on one hell of a performance. She performed probably half of her singles from the Fallen album and from the Open Door album. They were fantastic. Call Me When You're Sober, My Immortal, Wake Me Up. It was honestly a phenomenal act. I was legitimately cheering and losing my mind, of course, by the end. It was great. So I was legitimately cheering and losing my voice by then, and it was great.